Well, we love to hear from you, and so many of you communicate with us via email. We want to answer some of the email questions you've sent in. And Pat, this first one is from Susie, who says, my coworker has a really bad attitude, and whenever anyone confronts her about it, she tells them to, quote, judge not, lest ye be judged. Does that mean we should not address another person's poor behavior?
No, it doesn't mean any such thing. I mean, she's hiding behind a scripture, and she's using it wrong. The Bible also says, by their fruit you shall know them. And somebody said, I'm not a judge, but I may be a fruit inspector. You need to confront people. Yeah. And if anybody sees somebody overtaking sin, they should go to that person, but maybe bring somebody else along and confront them and say, you don't understand. You know, you're ruining yourself and everybody around you. And this critical nature has got to stop. So, should you do it? Yes, you should do it.
Mm-hmm. This is John, who says, I know Jesus was the Son of God, but I find it confusing that he called himself the Son of Man. Did Jesus know he was God's Son?
Of course he knew it, but what he had to identify with people and show them, he used that term to indicate that he was a representative man. He was 100% human as well as 100% God. That's the mystery of the incarnation, the mystery of Jesus. But nevertheless, he was 100% human. He was hungry, he was tired, he was sleepy, he felt pain. But the Bible says he was moved by the feeling of our infirmities. So yes, he knew who he was. He knew. Mm-hmm. When he was baptized, there was a voice from heaven that said, this is my beloved son whom I'm well pleased. God spoke to him. He knew who he was.
This is Shauna, who says, I talk to God throughout the day, but I always feel it's just as important to spend some time on my knees in prayer as well. My sister says she doesn't feel the need to pray on her knees. Does the Bible say anything about this?
Well, there's, you know, I worship and bow down before the mighty King of Kings. A lot of times in the Bible, they stood up and raised their hands and shouted hallelujah. I don't think the posture of your body is what's important. What's important is your heart. And are you humbling your heart before God? And that's what the idea of getting on your knees indicates. I'm humbling myself before the great God. But I don't think you have to get down on your knees. But if that's what you feel like, then do it. Don't somebody else tell you not to. It's your decision. It's not theirs.
This is Jane, who says, one of my cousins is into the occult, and I feel spiritual oppression whenever I'm around her. She is expecting a baby, and my mom wants me to attend the baby shower. I have mixed emotions about going. Do you have any insights for dealing with family members who are in such spiritual darkness?
Well, what you need to do is pray about it, and you need to bind that demonic spirit. But I'm not sure that I would participate in a happy time for that girl, it's your own call, but I think, what fellowship has Christ with Belial? You have no fellowship with somebody who is in the occult and demonic. The only reason that you would go is to set them free, and you don't want to go in a baby shower and say, in the name of Jesus, I rebuke you, Satan. I'm not sure that would be appropriate.
Right. This is Stacy, who says, after seeing all the news coverage of massive blizzards and Haiti's earthquake, I'm realizing that I'm not very prepared to face a natural disaster, but I don't want to go overboard. Do you have some suggestions of what kinds of things I need to have on hand for emergencies like these?
The wise man sees the danger and he hides himself. The fool goes on and is punished. I think everybody should have a well-stocked first aid kit. Everybody, where possible, should have some source of water or a purification mechanism. I mean, there are little pills where you can purify dirty water, and you need something like that. If possible, if you could have as much as 6 months cash available to you, not necessarily an account in a bank, but cash money, $20 bills, $100 bills, whatever. So if the banks are closed, you can still buy stuff. I think a certain amount of food, dry food, canned food, you know, MREs, what have you, just so you have something to eat. I think the first few weeks after disaster are the most important time, and that's when you most urgently need food, shelter, water. they say that you need a battery-powered radio so you can listen to what's going on because the power might be out. I believe in having a generator. I just think generators are important. And, you know, it depends on how much money you got, but they're not all that expensive. You can have one standby. So if the power goes out in your community, you can still flip on your generator and you've got electric power.
Right. And batteries, you know, often house, my kids take the batteries for their things and I go to use a flashlight and they're gone. So it'd be good to put all that in one area.
They're flashlights that have big batteries too, kind of like storage batteries. Mm-hmm. So they're not just little ever-ready things, but they're bigger ones and they, you know, give you some illumination. But I think flashlights and that kind of stuff is just, you know,
practical.
It's very practical, and I'd also keep your car filled up with gas.
Mm-hmm. This is Esther, who says, I am confused by God's timing. Sometimes he answers prayers right away, and other times it seems to take forever. How can I keep from being frustrated while I'm waiting for an answer from God?
Well, I don't think you need to get frustrated. You need to trust the Lord. If you trust the Lord, you won't be frustrated. Read Daniel. Daniel started praying, and apparently God sent Michael to help him, this archangel. But along the way, he had a battle. He had to go fight the Prince of Persia. Prince of Persia came up against him, and he had to fight him and beat him. And then he went on to answer the prayer. He said, from the moment your prayer went out, the answer was coming, but it took me 21 days because I was fighting this bad guy. Then I came. Mm-hmm. On the other hand, somebody like George Mueller, I understand he prayed 50 years for the salvation of somebody. And the man finally came to the Lord, I think, after Mueller's death.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's in God's time. Faith, you know, is what you have, and you have faith that God will answer. He'll hear and he'll answer. And, mm-hmm. you know, you trusted in him, but that, you don't get frustrated. Why do you get frustrated? It's his decision.
And his timing's always right.
It's always perfect. The sun always comes up at the right time.